हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर संदीप महामुनी, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, सदगुरु गाड़गे महाराज कॉलेज, कराड। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द पॉइंट फ्रॉम द टॉपिक मेटल सेमीकंडक्टर्स एंड सुपरकंडक्टर्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर द कंसेप्ट ऑफ मेटेलिक बॉन्ड। वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ मेटेलिक बॉन्ड इज एक्सप्लेन्ड विथ हेल्प ऑफ टू डिफरेंट थेरीज। फर्स्ट थेरी is called as free electron theory and second theory is called as band theory of metallic solids. So let us consider these theories one by one. But before going to discuss these two different theories, it is necessary to know first meaning of the metallic bond. So we know that different type of the metallic solids or different metals such as copper, silver, gold, they said to have metallic bond. So consider what is meaning of metallic bond. So metallic bond, the definition of metallic bond can be given like this. It is the force, attraction, linkage or binding which is responsible for holding all the metal ions tightly together in the lattice of metallic solid. So that type of the bond formed, it is called as the metallic bond. So once again consider how the definition of metallic bond is there. So force of attraction, linkage or binding which is responsible for holding all the metal ions tightly together in the lattice of metallic solid is called as metallic bond. So formation of metallic bond or what is concept of metallic bond, it is explained with respect to two different theories. So consider first theory of metallic bond which is called as free electron theory. So free electron theory of metallic solids, it was proposed by scientist Drude in 1900 and later on it was modified by scientist Lorentz in 1908. Then consider how the concept of metallic bond is expanded on the basis of free electron theory. So free electron theory, basically it is based upon two different assumptions. So first let us consider these two assumptions. So first assumption on which this theory is based, that is, in the theory electrons are considered. So we know that electrons are negatively charged. As same type of charges are there, one may assume that there is repulsion between electrons. So theory considers that there is no any mutual repulsion between the electrons. Same charges are there, but it is assumed that there is no any repulsion between electrons. Then second assumption of this theory, or the assumption on which this theory is based, it is that the potential developed due to all the positive metal ions is uniform throughout the crystal. So let us keep in mind these two assumptions, that is, there is no any repulsion between negatively charged electrons and potential field developed due to all positive charged metal ions is uniform. Now let us consider how the concept of metallic bond is explained on the basis of free electron theory. So according to properties of metallic solids, we say that in the lattice of metallic solids, all the metal atoms are arranged in a perfect arrangement, or they are arranged in a ordered manner. So such type of arrangement, that is perfect arrangement of constituent metal atoms in the lattice of metallic solid, it results into crystal structure of metallic solid. So we can generally show the structure of metallic solid by this way. So in the lattice of metallic solid, all these metal atoms are arranged in a perfectly ordered manner. So such type of perfect arrangement of metal atoms is called as the crystal structure. Metals, they are having low ionization energy. So as metals are having low ionization energies, they tend to be electropositive. So to acquire stable electronic configuration, metal atoms loses their electrons and they convert into positively charged ions, which are called as metal ions. So let us consider in the lattice of metallic solid how this formation can be given. All metal atoms, they are arranged in a perfect crystalline manner. So to acquire stable electronic configuration, these metal atoms, they loses their electrons and they convert into positively charged metal ions. So all the metal atoms, they get converted into positively charged metal ions by removal of electrons. So these positively charged metal ions, they are called as kernels. That is, these metal ions, they are called as kernels. So number of electrons, they are removed while conversion of metal atoms into metal ions. So kernels are surrounded by number of electrons. So these electrons, they are called as sea of electrons, or they are called as mobile electrons, or they are called as electron cloud, or it is called as electron pool. So in the lattice of metallic solid, now we are having the arrangement in which positively charged metal ions called as kernels are there, which are surrounded by number of free electrons which are moving freely across the lattice. Now see how the situation in the lattice is there. We are having positively charged metal ion called as kernel, and we are having negatively charged electron which is free to move in the lattice of the metallic solid. So it is always observed that there is attraction between oppositely charged species. So here we are having positively charged metal ions and we are having negatively charged electrons. So there exists a strong electrostatic force of attraction between positively charged metal ion called as kernel and negatively charged electron, which is responsible for holding all the metal ions tightly together in the lattice of the metallic solid. What the force? The force of attraction between these positively charged metal ions, which are called as kernels, and negatively charged electrons. This holds all the metal ions, that is these all metal ions, tightly together in the lattice of metallic solid. So that type of force of attraction, which is responsible for holding all the metal ions tightly together in the lattice of metallic solid, is called as metallic bond. Sometimes one may get confused with ionic bond. The definition of ionic bond is that the force of attraction between oppositely charged ions. That means in ionic bond we are having force of attraction responsible for holding positively charged cation and anion, which is negatively charged. But here somewhat situation is different. Here what we are having force of attraction between positively charged metal, or between positively charged metal ion and negatively charged electron, which is responsible for holding all the metal ions tightly together in the lattice of metallic solid. So that type of force of attraction, binding or linkage, is called as ionic bond. Then let us consider the concept of metallic bond by taking one particular example. So to explain again the concept of metallic bond, let us take into account formation of lithium crystal, or how the structure of lithium crystal is there. So to explain lattice of metallic crystal, that is lithium, or how the formation of metallic bond in lithium crystal is there, we have to consider electrons present in lithium, as well as we have to consider what type of crystal structure is exhibited by lithium. So it is observed that the electronic configuration of lithium having atomic number 3 is equal to 1s2 2s1 2p0. Then if we consider unit cell of, if we consider the structure of lithium, the structure of lithium crystal is body centered cubic type of the structure. That means in the unit cell of lithium, totally 1 plus 8 is equal to 9 lithium atoms are present. Now consider how all these lithium atoms are binds with each other and which type of bond is responsible for holding all the lithium ions tightly together in the unit cell of lithium. So the unit cell of lithium in plain way, it can be drawn like this. So here we are having all these lithium atoms which are arranged in a perfectly crystalline arrangement or in body centered cubic type of the arrangement. So lithium, it is having less ionization energy, so to acquire stable electronic configuration, lithium loses its electron present in 2s atomic orbital and it gets converted into Li plus ion. So all the lithium atoms get converted into Li plus ion. How they are converted? They are converted into lithium ions by removal of their electrons present in 2s atomic orbital or electron present in outer valence shell. So all these 9 lithium atoms loses their electrons present in 2s atomic orbital and get converted into kernels, or they get converted into Li plus ions. Here they are surrounded by number of electrons which are called as free electrons. So again consider the crystal structure of the lithium or unit cell of the lithium. So we are saying that the lithium is having body centered cubic type of the structure. So body centered cubic type of structure means totally nine lithium atoms are there. So each lithium atom, if we consider each lithium atom is having totally 4 atomic orbitals, that is we are having 2s, then 2px, 2py and 2pz. So as 9 lithium atoms are present in the unit cell of lithium, 9 lithium atoms are totally having 36 atomic orbitals. So 9 lithium atoms and all these 36 atomic orbitals, they get compactly arranged to form such type of the unit cell. 9 lithium atoms loses their one electron and convert into lithium ion. So these 9 electrons, they are free to move in 36 atomic orbitals of 9 lithium ions. So as plus charged lithium is there, negative charged electron is there, two opposite charges are there, one plus charge and one negative charge. So there exists a force of attraction between Li plus ion and negative charged electron. So that force of attraction between Li plus ion and negative charged electron is responsible for holding all the lithium ions tightly together in the lattice of the lithium crystal. So that type of force of attraction, linkage or binding is called as metallic bond. So by taking this lithium crystal, the formation of metallic bond can be explained by this way. So after seeing formation of this metallic bond with respect to free electron theory, let us consider what are merits and demerits of free electron theory. So the properties of metallic solids which are related with presence of free electron in the unit cell of lithium, all these properties, they are well explained with respect to free electron theory. So number of properties such as electrical and thermal conductivity, then melting point and boiling point, emission of electron from the surface of metallic solid, that is emissivity, all the metallic solids, they are having shining lustrous appearance, So such type of properties are well explained on the basis of the free electron theory. Then, besides having some of the merits, the theory is also having some of the demerits. So consider which demerits of this theory are there. So first demerit, the phenomenon of semiconductance is not explained on the basis of the free electron theory. Then different type of the calculations related with calculation of cohesive energy of metallic solids as well as calculation of specific conductance of metallic solid, it is not explained on the basis of the free electron theory. So it is first theory in which more emphasis is given on the presence of electron in the unit cell of the metallic crystal.